Hello students, after completion of haloalkanes and halogens, electrochemistry, chemical kinetics and the amines, it is a turn of new topic, namely surface chemistry. This is topic from physical chemistry and it carries 6 marks in the theory examination. There will be one question in part A which carries 1 mark, and there will be one question in part D4 which is only for physical chemistry question which carries 5 marks. Of course this 5 marks can be split as 3 plus 2 or 4 plus 1 or 2 plus 2 plus 1. In the KCET examination there will be 2 to 3 MCQs we can come across in KCET examination question paper. In the NEET and JEE mains examination, 1 or sometimes 2 MCQs will be asked on this topic. So it is one of the simplest topic, not much complicated calculations are required for this topic. So if you listen carefully what is taught in these classes, simultaneously your preparation will be covered. So now we'll start with this word, surface and chemistry. These are the two words we are looking into this name of topic. We can say surface is nothing but outermost layer of substance. For example, if this is the substance, this outermost layer we call it as the surface. So this is the outermost layer of substance, is called as surface. And for chemistry we have to take this word change here. So in surface chemistry, we deal with the changes which are taking place on the outermost layer of substance, which we call it as the surface. That's what we can make it out from this title, surface chemistry. Now if we look into the definition part of this surface chemistry, we can say that it is a branch of chemistry. Surface chemistry is a branch of chemistry which deals with phenomenon that occur at surfaces or interfaces. We should look into the meaning of this definition, because once we know what we mean by surface chemistry, then it is clear what we are looking into. So it is a branch of chemistry. There are various branches of chemistry, it is one of them, and we have to deal with the study of phenomenon. We use this word in broad way. Phenomenon is nothing but that which exists, which can be felt, which can be perceived. That is called as phenomenon. That occurs, which takes place on the surfaces, which is nothing but outermost layer of the substance, or the interfaces. Now what we mean by interfaces? If we have these two solids, this is its surface, this is surface of another substance. If we look into these two solids in contact, there will be the common boundary between them. That we call it as the interface. Due to their contact, there is one common area in these two surfaces. That we call it as the interface. Interface is what we use it in many ways, but in surface chemistry, what we mean by interface, I will just explain 3-4 points regarding this interface, because again and again we use these words and we should be very clear in the meaning of that. So regarding the interface, we should say that it is nothing but the common boundary between two bulk phases. Now phases means we can say this is one phase and this is another phase. It has its surface, and when they are in contact, the common thing which belongs to both of them because of interaction, that area, we call it as interface. What we mean by phase? Bulk means which is larger. What we mean by phase? Phase means anything which is chemically uniform. We can say this has one set of particle, this has one set of particle. So this is in one phase, this is in another phase. I am not talking about physical state. This is solid, that is a different thing. Phase we are talking about, which we can distinguish. It has one set of particle, it has another set of particles. So that which is chemically uniform, physically distinct, this is one set of substance molecules, this is another set of molecules. So physically they are distinct and they are mechanically separable. That we call it as the phases. We use them in many times, we use this word phase here. Of course, we will not go into again the technical thing into it, but that which is chemically uniform, physically distinct, mechanically separable, these are some properties of the phases. And the common boundary between these two phases we call it as interface. Just like international, between two, and phase is nothing but the kind of surface we are talking about. For example, you are listening to this class. What is the interface? What is the common between you and me? If you want to view this class, you have to go to our YouTube channel, our college YouTube channel. So that college YouTube channel is interface between you and me. You are understanding, this is the common thing. I have to upload this lecture on the YouTube channel, and you have to go to YouTube channel, then only you can view this class. So interface is nothing but common boundary between two bulk phases, and it is represented by, in surface chemistry, it is represented by either / or hyphen between two bulk phases. For example, this is a solid phase, this is one solid, and on this solid these gas particles are in contact, like this. These gas particles are in contact like this. So this is solid and this is gas. These are two bulk phases. And this is interface. This is interface. Like this, which I am just making it more dark, that is interface. And it is represented by this is the / because this is solid. And this is / and then this gas. It means solid and gas, they are in direct contact. Or we can place hyphen between them. The meaning is same. So whenever we come across such a representation, such a writing, we should say that this is one phase, they are in contact, there is interface between them, and the changes takes place at those interfaces. We have to learn in the surface chemistry. So it is represented by slash or hyphen between two bulk phases. There is no interface, no interface between gases. There is no interface between the gases. Why? Due to complete miscibility, as they are miscible, dissolve. We cannot have this gas and gas interface because this gas will dissolve into this gas. There will not be any interface. Only one type of system will be formed into it, which is uniform, which is homogeneous. Because whenever gases mix up, they form homogeneous mixture. So we should not deal with this gas and gas here in surface chemistry because they form the homogeneous mixture. Now, what are the phenomena which are taking place on the interface? There are many phenomena, few might have known to you. Corrosion is one phenomenon. On the surface of air, this is one phase, atmospheric oxygen with moist air, that is another phase, and this interaction starts on the surface. So corrosion, which is a surface phenomenon, very important reaction. If we have any mechanism to revert corrosion, it is extremely beneficial from industrial point of view. So corrosion is very important surface phenomenon. Or the electrode process, which you are learning in electrochemistry. The gases are released at anodes and cathodes. So at the anode, which is nothing but material, maybe the metal, or if it is inert, maybe the platinum, and the gases released there, hydrogen, oxygen, like that. So the electrode process is also surface phenomenon. Heterogeneous catalysis. Heterogeneous means which has two phases. Suppose there is a metal catalyst in solid state, and on that metal catalyst reactant gases, they are combined. That comes under the study of surface chemistry. Or we can say dissolution. In dissolution, it may be solid in contact with liquid, or it may be the gas in contact with the liquid. Or crystallization, where the solid is separated from the liquid. It is one of the important separation technique. So this solid and liquid is in contact. So here solid and gas is in contact. Solid and gas is in contact. Again the solid and gas is in contact. Maybe in dissolution solid in liquid in contact, or gas in liquid in contact. And here the solid and liquid, these are two phases we come across. So all these phenomena was the interface, and their study can be done in the surface chemistry. Now regarding this interface, two more points we can add, that this interface is few molecules thicker. This is few molecules thick in thickness, just molecular size, very small size in nanometer. The area is very small, and the area depends on size of particles in bulk phase. So which particles are being in some contact, that decides the area of the interface. These two points I have written for interface only. So what is interface? how it is represented, which are the processes taking place at interface, what is its thickness, how its area is decided. These are few points we are learning about the interface, because this new world we came across in the surface chemistry. So these two words must be clear to us. One is surface, another is interface. And whatever happening at this surface or interfaces, we are interested into it when we learn the surface chemistry. Now one last point in introduction, we can add that if we have the solid surface of metal, because metal is in the solid state, so surface of metal, to learn the surface chemistry, to learn the changes taking place on this surface, it should be ultra clean surface of metal. Now how to obtain this ultra clean metal? 10⁻⁸ to 10⁻⁹ Pascal pressure is applied, very very low pressure. We call this as literally vacuum, absence of the atmospheric gases is applied, and we get this ultra clean surface of metal. And it is, this particular metal is stored in vacuum. And why it is stored in vacuum? To avoid the interaction with the atmospheric gases, which are nitrogen and oxygen. So at a given point, every surface, even though it is invisible, there are many gas molecules may present on the surface, and we should clean it. One way is mechanical rubbing. Just rub this, just like when we sit in chair, we take care that we clean, and then we have to sit. Just you sit in the desk, you see whether it is clean or not, like that. So surface, we have to just wipe it out, whatever molecules is present. This one way, but this will not work, because atmospheric gases are continuously reacting with its surfaces. So care should be taken that they should be ultra clean. Here ultra clean means there will not be any traces of the atmospheric gases on the surface, and this is done by placing that particular metal surface in the vacuum at a very very low pressure. Now there are three features of surface chemistry. Features of surface chemistry in which we are interested, our syllabus is regarding this. One is called as adsorption, another is called as catalysis, and third is called as colloids. These are the three features, these are the phenomena we are interested in: adsorption, catalysis, and the colloids. These colloids and adsorptions are new word for us, but that is the part where we are learning this topic. So these three features we have to learn one by one. So we start learning with the adsorption. From this the topic starts, from our examination point of view. But this introduction part is also important. You go through this in NCERT textbook, I explained it just now, because the question can be asked from any point. Many students, they ignore the introduction part and they just see the syllabus and they start looking into syllabus. But this is not the way. You should read the introduction part also, because from that part our understanding will be better regarding that particular topic. So now we have to start with the phenomenon of adsorption. Adsorption, very important surface phenomenon. Now we are learning only surface chemistry, those chemical changes which are taking place on the surface. Now before learning the adsorption, or before defining adsorption, we will take four examples and try to understand these four examples clearly. We will take one container here. We will connect this container to this
gas here. That may be any gas. It may be sulfur dioxide, it may be ammonia, it may be methane, it may be nitrogen, it may be hydrogen, any gas. Not the mixture of gases. I have written here many gases, but any gas you can enclose here. There will be mercury level here. Initially, these two levels are equal, it means pressure is equal. And there is one, this wall here. We can open this wall and allow these gas molecules to create pressure. Due to creation of this pressure, the height of mercury in one arm will increase because they are pushing this mercury level to another. We will register this pressure and it will be P1. Now we will have the same setup. Same setup. Same container, even though the diagrams are not identical twin here, but you can just see this, that these gas molecules are there. But now we will add our own substance. We call this as the activated charcoal. Charcoal. Coal is nothing but carbon. And char means which is obtained by charring, means at heating very high temperature. Powder. Powdered carbon, which is porous, having porous, pores into it. So what we observe when we measure the pressure here, again by the same setup here, manometer like this. What we observe is that the pressure is now P2 and P1 is greater than P2. Means here, when that activated charcoal was not there, pressure registered is more. And when the same amount of gas and activated charcoal is placed, pressure has been reduced. What conclusion we can draw here? We can say that gas molecules accumulates on the surface of charcoal. So what we can say? The gas molecules have been accumulated. They are present together, accumulation. And they are not free to make changes in this mercury level. And that's why pressure has been reduced. This is our observation, experimental observation. This is example number one. Example number two, we can see that if you have one dye which is called as methylene blue dye, which has of course blue color, and into that you add animal charcoal, even though these names are new for us, animal charcoal. Coal means carbon obtained by charring. Animal means it is obtained by the destructive heating, very high heating of the bones. Calcination of bones is done and this type of powder substance are obtained. And we shake this mixture. Methylene blue and animal charcoal, we take in test tube and we will just shake it. So filtrate. Filtrate means which comes after filtration. It's colorless. Filtrate is colorless. Initially it has blue color, but now it is colorless. So what conclusion we can draw? We can draw the conclusion that colored molecules accumulate on the surface of animal charcoal. This is our conclusion. So we are using this word accumulation. Here also we use this word accumulation. Here gas molecules have been accumulated. Colored molecules have been accumulated.
surface of charcoal, surface of animal charcoal. Now third example, we'll take the raw solution of sugar. Raw means having colored impurity, yellow colored. Sugar factory, you can see this process actually taking place. It is passed through the beds, chambers of animal charcoal. And what we observed here is that colorless solution of sugar. So what conclusion we can make here? The conclusion we can make here is that colored impurities, raw means which is having impurities, colored impurities are accumulated on surface of solid, which is nothing but here animal charcoal. Once again, animal charcoal. So this colored impurities is the substance which is accumulated on the surface of the animal charcoal. Look at the last and fourth example right here. We have humid air, air with moisture, and you allow this to be in contact with silica gel substance, which when you purchase a bag, there will be a small pouch in that bag. The whole moisture has to be absorbed, otherwise it will, due to oxidation, it may smell, we may get bad smell. So that is present in that bag, some small pouch, that silica gel is there, and we get the dry air out of it. So what we can say in the fourth example, the water molecules which are present in this humid air accumulates on the surface of silica. So here we have water molecules, they are accumulating on the surface of the silica gel. So what is common in all these four examples? There is accumulation of one substance on the surface of other substance. And this process of accumulation is nothing but we call it as the adsorption. So I'll write definition here so that you can understand this definition and the examples given. We can say that process of accumulation together, accumulation, we use this word again, accumulation coming together of molecular species on the surface, then in bulk, they won't enter into the bulk. Will the word, you always use penetration when they enter into bulk. We are talking about accumulation, just gathering on the surface of solid. Then in bulk, on the surface, then in bulk of solid or liquid is called adsorption. Adsorption, look at this word. Another word we know, absorption. If we take this sponge deep in water, molecules will penetrate. It is not that just they only remain on surface. that is absorption. You are absorbing chemistry, means it is going into your mind. It's not just depleting from your eyes back, right? So absorption is taking that substance in bulk, penetrates, that is called as absorption. We are not talking about that. We are talking only on the surface. On the surface, accumulation of molecular species on the solid or liquid, we call it as the adsorption. So this is the definition of the adsorption. Now we'll go into the next part, that whenever we talk about adsorption, there are two species, two substances involved in this adsorption. One is the molecular species that accumulates, and another one is the solid or liquid surface on which accumulation occurs. For example, this is solid surface, and on that these gas molecules are accumulating. They are from all sides. I am not drawing out from all sides, but you have to imagine they are from all sides. So there are two substances involved. One which makes its surface area available for accumulation, and other one which accumulates. We have to distinguish between them. And to distinguish between them, the molecular species that accumulate is called as adsorbate. And the surface on which adsorption takes place is called as adsorbate. You should not confuse into it, because many students, if they won't understand this, they make it reverse, because these are new words for us. So this is the gas molecule, this is the solid molecule, and this gas molecule is adsorbate, and this solid substance is adsorbate. Molecular species which accumulates is called as adsorbate, and the substance on surface of which this accumulation takes place is called as adsorbate. A is common here, D is common, S, O, R, B. Now here comes A and here comes E. A, B, C, D, E. A comes first in alphabetical, that is which is on the surface, and E comes after. So this is A and this is E. It is adsorbate and this is adsorbate. Just I am giving you the trick to understand this. I don't know whether it is good trick or not, but A is above it, because A comes first, so adsorbate are upper part. This is adsorbate on the surface, and this is adsorbate. So which is above is adsorbate, and which is below is the adsorbate. And together, when they have this accumulation taking place, process takes place, we call it as the adsorption. So what are the examples of adsorbate? In the last four example, in first example, it was activated charcoal. Second example, it was animal charcoal. Third example, sugar example, animal charcoal. Fourth example, moist air, silica gel. These are the adsorbate. And which are the example of adsorbate in those four example? In first case, various gases. Second case, the colored molecule. Third case, colored impurities. And fourth case, water molecules. These were adsorbate, and they were adsorbing on their corresponding adsorbate in the last four exam. If we allow this molecule to escape from this, like this, we can increase temperature basically and just allow this molecule to escape like this. We call this process as desorption. Removal of gas molecules from the surface of solid on which it is adsorbed is called as desorption. Opposite of adsorption, desorption, D means opposite of that. So desorption and adsorption, these two words, adsorbate, adsorbent, these two words and four examples and the definition of adsorption. These all things which you should understand and remember in a proper way. Now we have to distinguish between adsorption and the absorption. Adsorption and the absorption. We have to distinguish between them. The distinction is needed because both of these words seems to be similar. So adsorption and absorption. In first case we can say that accumulation of molecular species on the surface of solid or liquid. So here the basic word is accumulation. Here what we have to use is penetration. Penetration enters, penetration of molecular species into, here on and here into the bulk. Bulk means interior bulk of solid or liquid. Or we can say that this is surface phenomenon. Singular is phenomenon, plural is phenomena. We have used that phenomenon in definition of surface chemistry. It is bulk phenomenon. It occurs only on surface, exists only on surface, perceived only on surface, exists in bulk, perceived in bulk, felt in bulk. Rapid initial. Initially the speed is more and then speed decreases because it has restriction of the surface area. If gases are coming and they are just accumulating here, once this complete surface is filled, then speed will decrease because there is no other space here to get accumulated. So it is rapid initially, then speed will decrease and it occurs in uniform speed because the interior area is available, so the molecules can go inside and occupy those areas. So it occurs in a uniform speed and it is initially fast and then speed decreases. So most important thing is surface phenomenon, bulk phenomenon, accumulation or penetration into. These are the keywords here. So this is adsorption and the absorption. If you look into the diagram, suppose this is surface, the molecules are only on the solid surface, this is gaseous molecules, they are only on surface, and for absorption they are inside. That is called as the absorption. If two processes takes place simultaneously, adsorption and absorption together, we call it as the sorption. So sorption is the word used for adsorption and absorption taking place simultaneously. Adsorption, absorption, sorption, desorption. These are the four words we are using, and you should know what exactly they mean. Now, I will give you two examples again to understand this whole phenomenon. If we take the ammonia gas, adsorb on and absorb into. This ammonia gas is adsorb on charcoal. We have seen that example, first example, pressure decreases because of that adsorption. It absorbs into water. If we allow ammonia gas to enter into water, it enters into water, reacts with it, forms ammonium hydroxide, because ammonia is soluble into water, so it is absorption. Or we'll take the example of water vapors. They are absorbed on silica gel and they are absorbed into anhydrous calcium chloride. It absorbs moisture. In fact, it is used to detect whether water is formed or not, because it's a substance which absorbs it. So same substance can be adsorbed or absorbed if we allow it to be in contact with the different type of surfaces. In one, it only remains on surface. In one, it penetrates. Remains on surface, penetrates like this. So this is two examples. One more example that I have mentioned in our textbook, so that also I have to see. One is the this ink and chalk stick example. Many times you might have done this experiment also. Now in this ink there is solute, ink solution, and there is solvent. Solute is color, pigment, which gives color to the ink, and solvent is colorless. If we allow this ink solution to be in contact with chalk stick, colored molecules remains only on the surface, and the colorless solvent enters into it. It remains, if that ink is blue, the color will be only on surface. If we cut this and see inside, there will be colorless. Solvent has been penetrated. The solute remains only on the surface. So one substance is adsorbed, another is absorbed. These are the two, three basic examples of the adsorption and absorption we have made. Now one last point we have to stress into. Why this adsorption takes place? What is the reason why this accumulation on the surface takes place? We'll take this solid surface. These are the various molecules here. This is one molecule, same molecule, even though okay, I have done this also. This mixes molecule at bulk interior, and this is molecule at surface. There is difference in the surrounding environment of these molecules. One which is in bulk, surrounded by other molecules from all sides, upside, downside, these are the attractive forces applicable. So those molecules at bulk, attractive forces mutually cancels, because one is pulling from left side, right side, upside, downside. Consider this molecule. There is only one molecule which is from downside, even though I am applying its molecule of similar size due to space I am applying this molecule. There is no molecule from upside. So molecule at surface, they have unbalanced or residual force of attraction. Unbalanced force because molecule is attracted from downside but not from the top side. Right and left may be balanced, but bottom is not balanced by the top. So this molecule have this tendency. That is, some other molecules, they are coming in contact with them, they have tendency to attract them and retain them on the surface. Like this. These are molecules from other phases. They are attracting them and retaining them so that their forces are balanced. So that their bottom force is balanced by the top force. So what is the basic reason for that absorption? It is because the molecules at surface, they have this unbalanced or residual force of attraction. And to satisfy those forces, to nullify those forces, they have tendency to attract the other molecules with which they come into contact, attract them, and they retain them so that their forces get balanced. This is the basic points. We look into detail of this cause in next class also. So what is important is understanding definition of surface chemistry, understanding definition of adsorption, adsorbate, adsorbent, desorption, sorption, understanding the difference between adsorption and absorption, examples of adsorption, examples of adsorption and absorption together, and one substance adsorb on which substance and absorb in which substance. Right, we'll go into detail of that. Some technical word we are using, but I hope you understood this discussion. Not at all difficult topic. It is one of the topic, you listen carefully. There is no difficulty in solving questions in theory and MCQs. Only you have to listen patiently, because not much complicated concepts are involved here. I hope that you will do that. See. Thank you for watching.